expect me to do? Let Georgie take the rap for something that Doreen had done. Besides, I've warned her a dozen times. Anyway, one night in the pound isn't going to kill her. Might even knock some sense into her. You could knock that smirk off your face too, young lady. It's about time you learned to use your brains instead of your fists for a change.
What the hell have you done to Doreen, goddammit?
She did it to herself, Judy.
Really? I don't suppose this bitch here had anything to do with it
now,
either.
Now, just a minute. You weren't here. You don't know what you're talking about.
I know what I'm talking about, all right. You've done the dirty on a kid who always looked up to you like her own mother. Well, I've had it with you. And I'll tell you something else, too. You go shoving your weight around in Doreen's direction anymore, and you're going to find me there shoving you right back.
You all right? You want to take it easy, you know.
Oh, come on, Hazel, stow it, will you?
Come on, Jude. You're getting yourself all worked up, and it's not good for you. Why don't you just calm down and talk it over with Georgie and Bea?
Talk it over with Georgie? That conniving little bitch, you've got to be joking.
You're being a bit hard on the kid, aren't you?
No, I'm not. Oh, I've met that type before. Just uses people up, twists them around her finger. I mean, look at the way that she's got B conned.
I don't think that she's got B conned.
Of course she has. Oh, B fell in for that feet first, didn't she? Strutting around the place like a mother hen.
You wouldn't be jealous, would you?
Come off it, Hazel.
All right. But why don't you go and talk to B? She's only doing this because she feels sorry for Georgie. I mean, the mother's a bloody drongo. No wonder
the kid's
screwed
up. What am I going to say to her? Am I going to say to her, cut out this mother stuff, give the kid a swift kick and send her packing? She'd be at my throat in a minute. Oh, no way. I'm not going to go crawling to B. It's time that she just admits that she's at fault, and I won't be speaking to her till she does.
Suit yourself. I think you better get that mess cleaned up, though. Before Vinegar Tits sees it.
Well, that's the main reason for all this trouble. I knocked her back. I didn't know the dykes got that nasty when they strike a strike. Still, you put it in the right place, though, huh?
Look, before you go any further, Judy and I have been mates for a long time. I didn't exactly enjoy what I did.
Yeah,
cool. You got something to do someplace else?
Huh?
I want to talk to Bea for a minute. Do you mind?
Yeah, sure. I'll catch up with you later, Bea.
Don't go getting into any bother, okay?
Who, me?
Don't you think this thing has gone far enough?
What?
You know.
No, I don't know. What are you on about?
You and her. And Judy and Doreen. Geez, we used to be mates. All of us together.
Nobody asked you.
I know. But somebody's got to do something to patch things up.
Are you blaming me for what happened?
No, of course not.
Well, good, because as far as I'm concerned, all I have done is to try and help a kid who can't help herself and no one else can handle. Now, if that's a crime,
all
that's...
All right. But couldn't you have done it without all this upset and having Doreen put in the pound?
Doreen brought that on herself. She was going to let Georgie take the rap for something she did. Now, I wasn't going to let that happen because Georgie's had a rough enough time as it is.
OK. Well, what about Judy?
Yeah, what about her trying to muscle in on me?
That's not true, Bea. She wouldn't do that.
Well, she's done it once before, or have you forgotten?
Only on account of that Sharon Gilmore. Judy's not out to topple you, Bea. She's only interested in getting things back to the way they was.
Well, there's one very good way of doing that. And that's keeping out of things that don't concern her.
I think I'll go back to the rec room, watch a bit of telly.
Yeah, you do that. Hazel, have you got another load ready for me yet?
Yeah, over there. Judy can get it, can't you, Judy?
I asked Hazel.
Yeah, but...
Oh, get it? Yeah, my well, get it my bloody self.
Is everything all right in here, Smith?
Oh, good morning, Miss Bennett. Yes, thank you. No worries.
Miss Bennett, I would like to request to be transferred to the garden. It's a bit overgrown.
All right. It's about time someone took an interest.
Can I go with Judy, Miss Bennett?
No, you can't. That will leave the laundry short-staffed.
Well, it's just...
Don't worry, Miss Bennett. We'll manage.
All right. Come with me. I'll get you some tools.
Well, anyone else want to go? You better make your arrangements right now.
All right, Burns, on your feet.
Well, what do they dob me in for today?
Who?
Me so-called mates.
Nobody's dubbed you in for anything.
As I understand it, you were the sole cause of the incident which led to your being placed in solitary.
Now, have I been misinformed, Doreen?
No, Mrs. Davidson.
Then why are you trying to blame other people?
I'm not trying to blame anyone else for the blue. It's just that Georgie kid was really getting on my wick, and I suppose I did lay a lot of... Well, I say a few things to her.
What sort of things?
I can't remember exactly. All I know is it got out of hand, and the next thing I know, there was an all-in brawl going on.
And B. Smith rightly informed Mr. Fletcher and Miss Bennett that you were the cause of it, which is the real reason for your attitude now, isn't it?
Well, she's supposed to be my friend, Mrs. Davidson. I didn't think she'd dob me in just on account of a stupid kid that's been here a couple of weeks.
Yes, a kid, as you say, against whom you obviously bear a grudge, which is stupid and childish, and you shall be treated accordingly. You may return to the main area of the prison, but you will forego any other privileges for the rest of the week. Is that clear?
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
Mr. Fletcher. And Doreen... I don't want you bearing any more grudges, particularly against B. Smith, who, in my opinion, acted very sensibly under the circumstances. Off you go.
Everybody's had a gutful of B. Smith. Surely you can see that.
Everybody?
Oh, well, at least 60%, I'd say. And there's more coming over to your side by the minute.
What is this, a bloody election campaign or something?
Oh, you know what I'm getting at, Judy. We're all sick of B. Smith lording it over us, that's all. And we reckon now's the time for a change.
I get it. You want to use our argument as an excuse to topple her out and put me in power, right?
Oh, you've got to admit, she's been asking for it lately. And with the way the women are showing support for you over this feud,
there is no feud, Mouse. Can't you get that through your thick skull? Now, you listen to me. If you want to topple B, you go right ahead, but you keep me out of it. And don't you use me or our argument as an excuse either, because that is between B and me and no one else.
Oh, come on, Judy. The women are already taking sides, and B certainly ain't telling her troops to stay out of it because she knows it's for real. She's on the way out, and you're on the way in. So you'd better get used to it.
What is this place? The morgue?
Just do your work, Georgie.
Yeah, but no one's talking. We got rid of that client,
right? On you go, Burns.
Well, he's back.
Where's Judy?
She's working in the garden with Mouse.
Whose idea was that?
Judy's.
Mr. Fletcher, could I go and work in the garden, please?
No, you can't, Burns. You're on loss of privileges. You know what that means. Now get to work.
Job off, it's my job.
Go easy.
No, I'm a little bitch.
Hey, B, when you're on loss of privileges, does that mean you can't use the rec room?
Among other things, yes.
Oh, great. We'll have it all to ourselves.
That's enough, Georgie.
Do it. She's only baiting you. If you take the bait, you know where you'll end up.
Yeah, me so-called mates will make sure of that.
I'll knock it off and don't be so stupid. B had to dob you in before. Don't make her have to do it again.
Whose bloody side are you on?
That rotten little bitch has got you all conned, hasn't she?
Yeah, have a go.
I said shut up. Come on. Get some fresh air.
Don't make waves, Doreen. You'll only come off second best.
Hey, Jude, Doreen's out of the pound.
Yeah, well, I think I'd better go and talk to you. Join the others.
Yeah, okay.
Hey, what's up with you?
Judy, this place has fallen apart.
Yeah, fallen apart into two groups, you mean, them and us.
What's happened?
Oh, while you were in the pound, B and I had an argument. It got pretty heated. And as far as I'm concerned, it's just between B and myself. But have a look. Well, apparently they've taken sides. That's my group on the left.
Your group? Well, what do they want?
They want to take B off the pedestal and put me on it.
What do I have to choose?
You can't sit on the fence, Hazel. You've got to pick a side.
I could get my head kicked in if I make the wrong choice.
Make sure you don't.
Hi. Hazel. It's okay, mommy, eh?
What do you want?
Got a bag? Got a light?
How are you off with socks and underwear?
What was that?
Well, you already bit me for a fag and a light. You know, socks and underwear.
Ah, I get it. It's a joke. Very good. I've got one for you. Some of the others were saying that you and Judy Bryan are teaming up against B. They reckon that's what you and Mouse was talking about outside. That'd have to be a joke, wouldn't it?
Yeah, I'd reckon.
That means that you're with B and me and the others, right?
Yeah, right. Of course I am, all the way.
Great. Can't tell you how happy that makes me feel. Because if you were with the others, well, when the time comes, you'll be like smoking. Be a health hazard. Stay healthy.
Yeah, sure, Georgie.
Lizzie, what are you doing here?
I've got to talk to somebody, Mr. Andrews. Something going on around here and I don't like it.
What, the lessons? Aren't you happy with...
No, it's got nothing to do with that. Listen, if I told you something real confidential, you wouldn't say nothing. Oh, yes, of course you would.
Lizzie, what's wrong?
Well, tell you the truth, I'm worried, Steph.
Well, do you want to tell me about it?
I can't.
Why not?
I just can't. Did you ever hear of Frankie Doyle?
Doyle. No. Who's he?
It isn't a he. It's a she. Anyway, she's dead. A long time ago, she decided to have a go at taking over from B. Smith. And we all had to take sides. I mean, all of us. No sitting on the fence. If we had, we'd have copped it from all sides. Anyway, there was this blue going on. And finally, a riot. And a man was killed. Bill Jackson, Mrs. Morris's first husband.
That's awful.
You reckon? That was kindergarten playtime.
Compared to what?
Compared to what's going to happen now. If they all get off the fence and they all take sides, this whole bloody joint's going to be split right in half.
Here, help yourself to those.
What's this thing?
My membership card. You can count me in.
What in? What's this all about?
I just got the treatment from Georgie Baxter a while back. Join up with them or else.
Yeah, well, you better go and join up
now,
with them.
Hang on, Jerry.
You listen to me a minute. I've already told Mouse, and I'm telling you now, as far as I am concerned, there will be no taking of sides.
Well, I know that it was a lousy program, Georgie, but some of us are watching it.
Kill it.
Now, you listen to me, you bitch. If you're looking for a fight, you just say so because I will be happy to accommodate you. And I won't end up in the pound like Doreen did either. And you two can just stay out of it. I'm not B. Smith. I don't need to have the help of 1,000 people.
My name in vain.
Just remember what I said. Anytime, any place, just you and me.
What was that all about?
You know, that maniac. Probably going through change of life.
I warned you, no aggro.
Who's aggro? Looking a bit unhealthy there, Hazel.
You didn't look too hot yourself a few seconds ago.
That bitch!
Jude, what's wrong?
I'll tell you what's wrong. Georgie Baxter, that's what's wrong. She's in there now, pushing and needling, deliberately stirring. And B can't see it. She's protecting the bitch even now.
God, I wish I could get my hands on her. I'd kill her.
Oh, she'll get hers all right. Don't you worry about that. But she's got to get it clean, because any other way and the whole place will be split right down the middle.
Well, how are we going to do it?
I don't know yet. We just have to wait until B wakes up to her, that's all.
Yeah, if she ever does.
She will. Just a matter of time. But Bea'll have to make the first move because I am not crawling to her over that little twit.
How long have you been standing there?
I just walked
What's
in.
What's wrong with your own self?
I said I just walked
Sent
in.
Sent you along to spy on us, did they?
I don't spy on nobody, Dor.
What's the matter with you two for crying out loud? You're supposed to be mates.
My mates don't share cells with stirrers.
Oh, come off it, Dor. Wasn't my fault that she was put in my cell or that you were moved out. The screws thought that one up.
Well, I'm sorry, Lizzie. It's just everything. Being in the pound, loss of privileges, everything, you know?
Of course I do, love. That's why I came in to see you. I thought you might have needed a little company.
Oh, hell, it's all her fault. She's not even in the room and she manages to muck things up. What are we going to do about it, Jude?
Called for extra help?
Nobody. They volunteered.
Well, that's terrific, isn't it? Now they're even dividing it down the centre for territory. You work with B, you work in the laundry, you don't, you work outside.
Mm, that's about the size of it.
Morning, ladies.
Morning, Mr. Andrews.
How are things going? Any more trouble? It's all right. I'm aware of what's going on. You can talk freely.
And if you're aware of it, how come you haven't reported it?
Because I don't think it's that serious. I like to think it'll sort itself out.
Mm-hmm. Who told you?
No names, no pack drill. Anyway, that isn't what's important. What is important is to try to resolve this thing so that we can all get back onto an even keel.
Well, then I think you ought to talk to B. Smith. Tell her that none of this would have happened if she hadn't been protecting Georgie Baxter.
I don't think protecting is the right word. B volunteered to help Georgie, to guide her along a bit.
That's bull, you know that? I mean, she's been protecting her, giving her the kid glove treatment. She can't do any wrong in her eyes.
And how would you treat her?
I'd give her a kick in the bum, for starters.
And she'd kick right back. I hardly think that's constructive.
And you think this is? I mean, the whole camp's divided into two lots. Them and us. You're trying to tell me you know what's going on around here, are you?
Well, I know there's been some faction forming and a few arguments, ostensibly created by Georgie, but I'm not too sure about that.
She's got you bluffed too, you know?
I don't think so.
Well, I do. Look, Mr. Andrews, you come here at 9 in the morning, you go home at 4:30, you have an hour for dinner. You don't live here. You don't spend 24 hours a day here.
Yeah.
So how could you possibly know what's going on here? Yesterday, there was just Mouse and I out here in the garden. The rest of them are inside taking up sides. Today, they've taken sides, and there's the group in there with B and the group out here. Now, I don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. I don't even want to know. But I know in the meantime, Georgie's in there recruiting.
Well, then that's the answer.
What?
Give your two factions their own territories. Perhaps you could meet in the library in the evening instead of the recreation room. That will keep the two groups separate until this thing blows over. What do you think?
Well, it'd stop a few heads getting bumped together, I guess. Yeah, it's worth a try.
Well, I'll talk to the governor right away. If we keep the library open after classes, that gives us two areas where they can be segregated after working hours with a minimum of supervision.
Mr. Andrews, the women will continue to work in whatever areas they have been told to. If they wish to keep apart after working hours, they can go to their cells. I will not do anything which polarizes large groups of women under any circumstances. That would only make matters worse.
Surely you're not still going to the pottery class?
Indeed I am. And for the same reason, I am refusing Mr. Andrews' request for segregation. To do otherwise, to change the established order of things, would only seem to the women as a sign of weakness on our part. I am not prepared to do that.
The sooner we get out of here, the better I'll like it.
Yeah, me too.
You got a fag on you, Hazel?
I had. Want to know what happened to him? Ask her.
He smoked too much. Sorry, I overkicked your habit.
What did you do?
What's that matter? She's in with Bright. She deserves all she gets.
I'll decide who deserves what and
how. Yeah, but you...
But nothing. You gotta stop heavying people. There's enough trouble in here as it is. You keep on like this and you might just find yourself out on a limb, understand?
Yeah, sure, be whatever you say.
Talkative lot, aren't we? So you're a smoker, Miss Bennet?
Isn't that right, Hazel?
Yeah.
I see. Well, those of you who want to attend the pottery class had better get moving. And there'll be no smoking in the library. Come on.
Miss Bennet, is it okay if I go to classes?
It's voluntary, Smith. Please yourself.
Ta.
All right, ladies, take a lump of clay, a piece about as big as your fist will be. Take a seat and we'll get today's project underway. Clay modelling, like most things, is a matter of learning to walk before you can run. So we're going to start off with something simple and at the same time, something practical. And since you're nearly all smokers...
So I was giving up, though.
Watch him.
I thought an ashtray would be a good item to start off with.
What about a death mask for Georgie Baxter?
All right, who did that? Who threw that piece of clay?
Never mind, Mr. Andrews, the damage is done.
All right, you want to play funny games? Fine. Let's see how funny you think it is back in the laundry.
Oh,
lessons are cancelled. I'm sorry. Mr. Fletcher?
What happened?
A slight accident. Come in, will you?
Do you need a hand?
No, thank you. I can manage. Someone threw a lump of clay. I don't think it was meant for me.
I should hope not. But it doesn't excuse the fact that it was thrown.
I know.
Well, then you're going to punish the persons responsible.
No. Well, there's no real harm done. If it had happened to one of the women instead of me, I would have just told them to clean themselves up, which is precisely what I have done. Then I would have had a few words with them, which is what I intend to do now. Where are they?
Well, I'd guess that you want to talk to them, so I put them in the rec room. Mrs. Davidson, I hope you realize that this wasn't a minor prank. In my opinion, it could have developed into a major confrontation. There's no doubt now that women are divided into two separate camps.
I agree with you, Mr. Fletcher. And to avoid your major confrontation, I have decided to act upon Mr. Andrews' suggestion and leave the library open. Perhaps voluntary segregation at this time would be most prudent.
It was meant for me and she knows it.
You should have heard what she said to me.
Never mind what she said. What about your crack about me giving up smoking?
Yeah, and it was a real stupid thing to do, too, with Mrs. Davidson in the room and all.
What?
I'm telling you, I've just about had the lot of you. And I would have given you credit for more brains than to start a stupid stunt like that.
She's done it!
Never mind who pushed who or who started it. It was a stupid thing to do.
You're quite right, Smith. It was a very stupid thing to do. But fortunately, there was no real harm done this time. Hopefully, suspension of classes for the rest of the day will be sufficient punishment for all of you. And whilst I have your undivided attention, I might warn you, all of you, that I am aware of certain faction fighting which has been building for some days. I do not know the reason for it, but I do know it must stop. I have arranged for the library to be left open this evening, as well as the recreation room. I suggest you take advantage of this in order to avoid one another and to consider how you are going to resolve your differences. This is your first and only warning. Failure to settle this feud will result in all of you being confined to your cell and loss of general privileges. That is all.
Well, it was Baxter who threw it, not us.
Yeah, and you would have done nothing to provoke it, I suppose.
She was slinging off at us.
Why, baiting you, you mean. And, of course, you would have run true to form and accepted it. You're lucky that Davo didn't throw you in the pound, for crying out loud. I certainly would have.
What's going on, Baxter?
Just a minute.
No, just stay right where you are, Brian.
Look, I never did anything.
No, we didn't do anything.
That's enough. Obviously, Mrs. Davidson's warning wasn't enough for you. In view of that, all buyer privileges will be suspended until further notice.
What?
Come on, Baxter.
We never touched her.
Well, how much of this are you going to take, Jude?
Now, give it up, Meg. You don't have to keep working. We don't need the money, for God's sake.
Believe me, it's not the money, Bob.
What is it? I mean, what keeps you at a job where, by your own admission, your life is at risk?
That's nonsense.
Look, Meg, you told me how Bill was killed. Now, by the sound of things, a similar situation is developing there now.
It won't come to that.
No. Who's going to stop it? You?
Well, I can try. But turning my back on them or running away and leaving them isn't going to help them either. And it certainly isn't going to help me. I couldn't live with myself if I did that.
Look, Meg, you don't owe them anything. You don't owe them a thing.
Don't I? Bob, I haven't exactly had an easy life. Now, I've told you a great deal about myself, and I think you understand.
Of course I do.
Well, then you must understand that I am what I am today because somebody cared about me. Somebody took the trouble to lend a hand when things got rough and didn't turn their back on me. Now, surely I owe it to them and myself to give the same consideration to people who haven't got anyone else.
Like you did with that Margot woman, you mean? Where did that get you? Her, for that matter. She turned her back on you.
No, she didn't. Margot took a job as a stripper because she saw the chance to earn some more money, re-establish herself in the outside world. Now, despite what you and I may think about her occupation, at least she's not involved in anything that could end herself up in Wentworth again. Now, surely that has to be seen as a step in the right direction.
Well, I hope you're right.
Maxie? Reg? How are you? Still talks a lot, eh? Well, enjoy the show. We've got to get ready for my next act.
Making a quid, are you, darling?
Yeah. I do all right. What's it to you?
How's Wayne, boy? Is he getting his share?
Wayne does all right. He's got his own job. Doesn't need to bludge off me.
Oh, Wayne is working, eh? That's amazing, Reg. Where's he at?
He's got a job washing dishes at a restaurant on the other... What's it got to do with you, anyway?
Dishwasher. Well, he won't be getting enough, then.
Enough for what? He hasn't.
Right, he has. People I work for, he hasn't, you see. Of course, I told Wayne, boy, not to go for the big bunk and all, but little Wayne wouldn't listen, would he?
How much?
600. 1,000. The boss is getting a bit impatient, you know. Wants his money like yesterday.
You've got to give us some time, Maxie. A month?
Ah, the boss gets very nasty when he doesn't get paid on time.
2 weeks, then. That's all. Come on. Done you a few favours in my time. Just this once. Please.
All right, then. 2 weeks, but no more.
You're a real pal, Maxie.
Yeah, aren't I? But if the money's not paid in time, we'll just have to hand it over to Reg. You know what he's like, don't you?
Wish I hadn't tossed that packet out that she screwed up. At least I could have scrounged a few fag papers and re-rolled them.
Yeah, we should go and take her buy-up off her, see how she likes that.
We will do no such thing. Now, look, if we put one hand on her, the whole thing's going to blow up in our faces.
Well, what do you reckon's happening now? We haven't even touched her and look where we are.
Yeah, I know that. But getting at her isn't going to help anything.
Well, what is then?
Well, going straight to the top, I guess. In that case, it's B. Smith.
She's not going to listen.
Well, I will make her listen. I mean, we have done nothing wrong, have we? I mean, she's got to see that.
All right, we'll go and talk to B.
We will do nothing of the sort. I mean, look, if a whole bunch of us go trooping in there, she's going to think we're pressuring her. I don't want any more trouble.
So we'll draw lots.
Look, this whole thing started out as an argument between B and me, and that is how it is going to be sorted out.
You're not going in there alone,
sure? That's exactly what I'm going to do. And I want the rest of you to stay put, no matter what happens, huh?
Well, no matter what B says, it's not going to get us back our buy-up. And I don't reckon that Georgie Baxter should get off this lightly.
No, me neither. But when I turned the corner, I saw Judy and a mob coming towards me. So I just turned back to avoid trouble, you know? Who should I bump into but Fletch? Now, he must have thought they was out to get me or something because he stopped their buyer.
So you're telling me the whole thing was a misunderstanding?
Yeah.
Well, that gives us a chance to show that we mean well. We're going to share our buy-up with the rest of them.
Oh, hell, was you? It wasn't our fault.
Wasn't it? Why don't you tell them about the scream, Georgie? Tell them about messing up your hair. Tell them about asking Fletch to protect you from those nasty women who never even touched you. Go on, you tell them.
Are you saying Georgie's a liar?
I'm saying this conniving little bitch has set the whole thing up.
Why?
Because she wants to keep the feud going.
Well, from where I stand, you're the only one who wants to keep the feud going. Now, we have just agreed to share our buy-up with you, Locke. What more do you want?
I want you to see the truth, B.
She's just a dumb kid.
Now, how often have you said that? And now you're trying to convince me that she's clever enough to set this whole thing up.
She doesn't have to be clever. Animal cunning is the only thing that she needs.
Now, just hang on a minute.
Oh, B. Are you so busy protecting your mother image you can't even see what's going on here?
Oh. Were you telling the truth about what happened, Georgie?
Oh, here we go. Give me your mother doesn't believe me.
Georgie! And you get off her back. And as for you others, you can go back to doing whatever it was you were doing before. And what I said about sharing the buy-up with the others, forget it. I don't care if that lot rotten hell.
Talk to Wayne, please.
Wayne, huh?
Wayne Bradshaw, he works in here.
Oh, no, I used to, love. Sure, you reckon I'd still be doing this if he was here?
But I thought.
Mind you, he lasted longer than most of them do. 2 days he turned up for work, but, well, we haven't seen him since. What do you want him for, anyway?
Never mind.
You're up early?
Not really. Haven't been in bed yet.
Oh, yeah, well, I was going to call you last night. We had this big banquet on some society about having the 21st
or
something.
Don't lie, Wayne. I know you haven't been near the restaurant in days.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh. Had quite an education last night. Ran into a couple of old mates. You remember Maxie and Reg?
Love, listen.
I don't want to hear it. But you better think of something to tell them. Either that or get down and make sure your medical benefits are paid up. $6,000, Wayne. $6,000! How in the hell did you manage to get that far down the bloody drain?
Would you believe at one stage I was 9,000 up?
You what?
Yeah. After I got the job at the factory, I had a bit of a flutter. Couldn't seem to do a thing wrong.
So you kept on going, betting bigger and bigger all the time.
Yeah. I thought I could clean up and you and me could get
then
out.
Then all of a sudden it started to turn sour. You started losing. But instead of getting out, you started chasing it. And all this time I thought you were going to work, you've been getting in deeper and deeper. Of all the damn fool things to do! They set you up, Wayne!
What do you mean, set me up?
Well, that's how they do it. They get the suckers in and then... Oh, what's the use? You've been had, Wayne. And if you don't come up with that money real soon, they're going to break you into little pieces.
Margot, what am I going to do? You got to help me.
Right, buy ups in the rec room for those of you that still got it. The rest of you get to work. And remember, any trouble out of any of you, and I'll be down on you like a ton of bricks.
Good morning.
Morning, darling.
You know, I've just realized that mornings are the only time nowadays that we can be together without interruption. If you're not on night or evening shift, I've got my head stuck into a file or a pile of notes or something. I'll let it ring.
Don't be silly. It might be important.
And then again, it might not. Anna Morris. Oh, yes, she is. What? Oh, I don't know. Hold on, I'll ask her. Meg, it's Margot Gaffney.
What does she want?
She wants to know if that job you lined up for is still available.
I thought she already had a job.
Well, maybe she got goosebumps on her goosebumps.
Don't be vulgar.
Hello, Margot. What's the problem?
Oh, nothing much. Well, something's come up all of a sudden, and I could use a bit of extra cash.
Don't tell me you've lost your job already.
No, no. It's just that it's sort of urgent, and I reckon I could handle a couple of jobs, you know.
Yes, well, I don't know about the cleaning job, Margot. It might be gone. I'll tell you what I do. I'll look into it and then get back to you. Well, what's the urgency anyway?
Oh, I don't want to worry about it, Mrs. N. But if you could check out that job, I'd appreciate it. Thanks.
I wonder what that's all about.
Well, I wonder why they can't leave us to have our breakfast in peace.
Knock it off, Georgie.
What?
I said knock it off.
Here's some extra help for you. Well, come on, get to it. And no nonsense out of any of you.
How's it been?
Okay, so far. Tell you what, I'm glad you're here, though.
Hang on. You two can get the laundry in. I need Jenny here.
Well, go on.
Why'd you do that, Bea?
Won't do you any harm? Besides, it might ease the tension here for a while, anyway.
Transparent can you get? Well, if B. Smith thinks we haven't seen through her little scheme, she's got another thing coming. Now, she just wants us out of the way so they can plot their next move.
Yeah, barefaced bitch. Isn't it bad enough we have to collect their flea-bitten laundry? Hey, wait a minute. They might have done us a favour. Well, they've just had a buy-up, right? We missed out on account of them.
Yeah, so?
So, where are their fags and stuff now? I didn't see any in the laundry, did you?
No. So it must be in there too.
Exactly. I don't see why we should miss out.
Oh, nor do I.
Let's get into it. Milk. All right. Chips. Marshmallows. Bags, my brand.
I bags the Mars bar, though.
I know the outfit, Margot. The loan sharks. How much interest do you reckon we'd have to pay back on a $6,000 loan?
Effectively, 38%.
38%? That means we'd have to pay back,
$8,280.
We can do it, Wayne.
Mrs. Morris is checking out that cleaning job for me. Now, if I get it, it'll cover our rent and food. Then all the money I make at the nightclub can go towards paying off the loan. And I've arranged a part-time job for you at the club as well. Evenings only.
So you can keep an eye on me?
So we can get us out of the mess that you've got us into. Then, during the day, you can get another job. And all the money you make at it can go into the pot towards paying off the loan. Now, I reckon if we get our heads down and our tails up on this one, we can get clear in a couple of months.
I don't know. That's a lot of money down the drain.
Well, how do you think I feel? At least you had the pleasure of losing the bloody money in the first place.
All right, lay off me, will you? Hey, do you reckon you could talk to Maxie and Reg? Get them to give us some more time.
Not a hope. They want $6,000. The money or the body. Please yourself.
What about their special diet you were supposed to be on?
Oh, that's a lot of cobblers. New biscuits not gonna hurt anybody.
Yeah, don't blame me if you keel over, you silly old bat.
Hey, sunbuggers pinch me biscuit supply.
You sure?
Of course I'm sure. And me fags, all me fags are gone.
Check your locker.
Oh, the rotten fruit.
Clean as a whistle.
Me too.
That bloody Judy Bright and her mob have cleaned us out.
Say, have you had anything stolen?
Yeah, a whole damn buy-up's gone.
So is mine.
Well, that does it. This is the thanks you get for sitting on the fence. You've just lost me, Judy Bryant. This is war.
Wayne, how'd you go with the fight? What's he doing here?
Oh, come on, Margot, don't be like that.
Wasn't talking to you, Bazza. What does he want?
He's going to help us out.
We can look after ourselves, Wayne. We don't need him.
And you don't need that bunch of sharks, I can tell you that much.
Meaning?
Meaning Bazza's had deals with him before. Ain't you, Baz?
Yeah, worst thing ever done for myself. See, what they do is they give you the loan, and when you've paid half of it back, they demand the balance. Of course, you can't pay. I mean, if you could, you wouldn't want the loan in the first place, would you? But then they get you to sign a different contract at a different rate of interest. Higher. They'll have you paying it for years. And if you don't pay, well, need I say more, Margaret?
But you said that you borrowed money from them.
Right. A couple of thou. Would have finished up costing me 10.
So how did you get out of it?
Same way as I'm going to help you out of the mess you're in.
How?
Payroll job.
No! No, no, Wayne. Look, you said. You promised. This time we're going straight. No, not on, Wayne. There's got to be another way.
There isn't time, mate. Remember, you said it yourself. The money or the body?
Who else is in on this job?
Just us three. Yeah. Three-way split. Well, what do you say, Margot?
No guns.
What? Me?
I know you better. You're a trigger-happy little...
It's all right, Margot. It's all right. No guns. We won't need them on this. It'll be a pushover. Hey, Bess?
Yeah. Pushover. Put that cigarette out, Mouse.
Oh, yeah, sure, Mr. Fletcher.
What a wife.
You want it? You can have it.
Oh, you little...
You're satisfied now, are you?
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again.
but that was on the outside. And things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too.